Although many made Apple's incremental 2015 iPhone upgrades predictable and boring, the fact of the matter is the cash cow iOS handheld family has gained serious fickleness points with the 5C 2013 launch and last year's 6/6 Plus split. Therefore, the sky is the limit for what Cupertino will bring to light in 2016, and we could see anywhere between 2 and 4 new iPhone models released over the next 12 months. It's unlikely the low-cost, plasticky 5C gets a held-up sequel, but the 5S should spawn a diminutive spin-off of sorts. That's according to often authoritative KGI Securities analyst Ming-Chi Kuo, who can't zero in on a more precise rollout timeline than the year's first half, yet has it on good authority this will resemble the 5S from an aesthetical standpoint, and pack the A9 chip of the 6S and 6S Plus. Advanced processing power and any guaranteed metallic construction suggest we'd also be dealing with a miniature iPhone 6S, but Apple reportedly plans to skip 3D touch capabilities for the 4-inch 6C, thus keeping the price significantly lower. Meanwhile, the 5.5-inch iPhone 7 Plus could itself be distinguished from the 4.7-inch 7 by offering 3 instead of 2 GB RAM for smoother than ever multitasking. That sounds like far too rapid evolution for Apple, which barely equipped the 2014 6 and 6 Plus configurations with 1 gig of memory, but obviously, we're keeping our fingers crossed, and hoping the logical sock leap to A10 isn't the only major hardware upgrade in the pipeline. Speaking of chips, TSMC is expected to act as the sole supplier of both A9 and A10 parts in 2016, as Apple continues to test the Intel waters behind closed doors, and Foxconn should exclusively score the iPhone 6C assembly contract.